This is a Switch that everybody knows. I mean, this is on shelves everywhere, even in supermarkets, and you can tell right away by just looking at the Switch that the ports are very close together. They share the shield, so they share the ground as well. If you open this up, you're gonna see that there's actually just two pieces of hardware in here. There's the termination IC, which is all integrated, and then the actual Switch, which is right there. So for the past couple of years, a lot of manufacturers have come out with audiophile switches. But the problem with those is that they are 99% of them are mods. They're just modifications of this. So they clone this, they take the main PCB, and what they do is they upgrade either the power supply and or the clock, the oscillator. And that leads to some very interesting layouts. Like for example, some of the manufacturers claim they have this super high precision, low drift oscillator, but then they have to mount, because they're using the same PCB as these guys, they have to mount it on a daughter board and then run a cable down to the main PCB. So, you know, it's a mod. It's fine, it works, it's definitely better than this, but it's nowhere near something that was conceived from scratch to be an audiophile switch. Okay, so we started with a blank slate, and this was conceived almost a year ago to be a really, like an audiophile switch. So if we start with the PCB itself, it's got six layers. That means that the signal is very, very contained in there. There's no radiation, there's little radiation that comes out, very little that can get in. Inside here we have six linear power supplies. They're very low power, that's why, you know, they fit in here. But six linear power supplies. Over here we have one, and you know, it's switch mode. It's just a buck converter, as it's called. So we also have a very high precision oscillator, but it's built right next to the main switch engine. So you can tell from the physical distance between the ports that we also took care to reduce as much as possible, not just electrically, but also physically, the interference and the crosstalk that can come up between the different connections. The last interesting thing about this is that of the five ports, the first three, 1, 2, and 3 are gigabit ports. They're gigabit capable. And the last two are actually limited to 100 meg. We did that on purpose because at 100 meg, we can control even better how the noise reacts, and we can just control it better. So we recommend that 1, 2, and 3 are used upstream towards the router and internet, and you know, if you have any other devices on your network, and 4 and 5 are used downstream towards your streamer. Okay. So yeah, let's hear it. That's all great, but if it doesn't sound better, it doesn't matter. Katie Pruitt, again, first with the TP-Link and then with the QNAP.
Marching in line in the halls of my Catholic school. Seven Hail Marys, if I copped an attitude.
Cables over. Okay. So one. Two. And three. Just give it a couple seconds so that I can reconnect to all the devices. There's a hit back. and play.
Marching in line in the halls of my Catholic school. Seven Hail Marys if I copped an attitude. God was a word I had spoken, but I hardly knew. Kneeling down at the altar with no clue who I was talking. Stumbling around Athens with frat boys in hot pursuit. Left me staring at the ceiling, pissed off and feeling used. Wasted and worn out and wondering where do I fit?
Deeper, more detailed and all that, it's much more effortless. It's much more natural sounding than it was before. So for the second and final song, we're just gonna upgrade the power supply, the external power supply. So I'm gonna play a song as it is, and then I'm gonna replace this cable that comes from the original switch mode power supply that comes in the box with this blue cable that is coming from the our external linear power supply. Okay?
They say Paris is dead. Lived through London, drank through Memphis. The things you live by were once just a guess. And there ain't no glory in the West. No, there ain't no glory in the West. Hard to think on your feet. Tired of begging them just to compete. Shoot to win can feel so bittersweet, but you take what you can get. 'Cause there ain't no glory in the West.
Right, I said before, I'm gonna unplug that and power the QNET with the Q source. So again, just give it a couple seconds so that it reboots. Press back and play.
They say Paris is dead. Lived through London, drank through Memphis. The things you live by were once just a guess. And there ain't no glory in the West. No, there ain't no glory in the West. Hard to think on your feet. Tired of begging them just to compete. Shoot to win can feel so bittersweet, but you take what you can get. 'Cause there ain't no glory in the West.
Very very different, right? It's very clear that, you know, the voice is changing, the guitar in the back, and the silence around him. Anyway, that was our probably the shortest demo that we've ever made. And thank you for coming. If you have any questions about the QNET or anything else, just let me know. Okay, I'll be here. Thanks.